Hi, welcome back to Willey Farms. I'm Donna Cavender, and we've got a great show for you today. Our first segment's going to be on kitchen gadgets. You'll find out some new things you maybe never seen before. We're also going to show you how to cook with spaghetti squash. And we're going to be right back here to show you a great recipe using fresh local produce. So I hope you'll stick around for that. Willey Farms is on Route 13, very easy to find. If you're traveling on Route 1, you get off North Smyrna, travel north, and we're right here on the right-hand side. If you're coming from the north, travel south on Route 1 and get off at Odessa. Get on Old Route 13, come down south just a few miles, and we're here on the left-hand side. You can't miss us, Willey Farms, Route 13. And if you'd like to check us out online, that's www.willeyfarmsde.com. Now let's go find out about those gadgets. Well, when you want to talk about gadgets and fun things, this is where you want to be here at Willey Farms. We've got a ton of things that are from a brand new line, and Hayden's here with me. And Hayden said he wanted to do the gadget thing because he doesn't know that much about gadgets, right?
Right. So you want things that make cooking and just everything, hosting a party, even easier.
Make it easier, right. And these are the coolest things. We have this entire line here. Now, here's a bowl. And like Hayden was saying earlier, it's kind of like working with leftovers and things like that. This is to make it easier. So you have a bowl. You have a bowl of leftovers, and you want to cover it. But you don't want to use saran wrap because you have to keep buying it and throwing it away. Well, look at this. This is the coolest thing. It's flimsy and floppy, but it's got a handle. You put it on a bowl like that and watch. So you don't have to worry about it sealing. It is sealed, but you don't have to worry about getting it off either, because all you do is just lift it there and it comes right off. I think that's the coolest thing.
Liquids aren't flying everywhere.
That's right. So we've got those. We've got these pot holders that are really pretty cool. We have the lids that are for smaller containers.
So yeah, when you're outside, say in summertime, you're trying to not have any bugs get in your drink, so you
exactly.
just put it right over your
just
iced tea.
Just put it right over there. Here's another lid for a little bit smaller bowl that works. And there's all kinds of, there's wine stoppers in this line here. They're so cute. That's the top, and there's where it goes into the bottle. Works great. And speaking of wine, let's move on down here. This is our kind of our bartender area, right. Isn't it? And got all kinds of mixers that are here. There's the Bloody Mary mixer, and it's got the sangria mixes, all kinds of things here. Of course, those aren't the gadgets, but we do have this one right here. It's not really a gadget, but it is a good thing to have in your kitchen. Have you ever used one of these?
I haven't.
Do you know what it is?
Well, it's a steamer. I see that there's a lot of people use for you put your veggies in there, right?
That's right. And it opens, fans open like that. So it depends upon how large a pan you have. You drop it down in your pan and you put just a little bit of water in the bottom and get it the water boiling so it steams. And then you put, as you can see on the box here, you put your vegetables in there and they get steamed. They keep their color, they keep all their nutrients, and it's really a good thing. So I like that steamer right there. What do we have over there in the basket? What do we have?
Well, we have plenty of a juicer here for limes or lemons, so you put that in there and just squeeze them right on
and
out.
So you can don't have to worry about the seeds getting out,
right.
And
keep
being
it right
messy.
In there, and so it's just the juice is going to come out
cool.
the bottom.
All right.
When you want to be efficient with your icing and when you're making cakes, we have a scraper to get out, you know, contours to the bowl.
Yeah, if you're just trying to use a spoon, it doesn't get it all that way.
So that's getting all the
And I was looking at this pastry scraper and cutter. This is a very cool thing. I like it a lot. When you're working with pies and doing pie crusts and things, you can scrape along your cutting board to scrape everything together. And really very cool on here, whether you can see it, I'm not sure, but there are inch increments marked out on this scraper so that you can tell if something is supposed to be an inch thick, then you can tell how that goes.
That.
And of course, it's always great to have, it's always great to have a good grater. And of course, there are different sizes, the larger sizes, like for maybe your cheeses, and then the smaller, and then the even smaller. So it's always good to have a grater like that. So what do we have here?
Well, pineapple cutter, when you have the core around the edges, nobody wants to eat that. So when you put your pineapple down, you take it off the top, you're just gonna slam it on down, and then you'll have your pineapple slices.
So all the outside just kind of falls away.
And
these, I've never used one of these, but I think I'm going to have to. This is...
Well, that's so when you're making pies, you put this in the center so the air can come out of it. So sometimes they get all inflated, pies do,
right. and then you take them out and they fall flat. Right,
yeah.
So you put one of these in, and they use them mostly with fruit pies.
Yes.
And you put one of these right in the middle of the pie, and as it cooks, the steam vents out, and that works out really, really nice. And then after you
make your pie, and it's all done, you have a spatula for it.
You've got this little pie scooper outer.
Because the first slice is always the toughest. You don't know, pies tend to stay there and everybody's afraid to get the first slice.
That's right.
This will alleviate everybody's fears.
That'll get it out there, good. And speaking of pies, also when you're making your own crust, not everybody does that now, but when you are making your own crust, what you need to do is cut cold butter into the flour mixture and things, and you use this to do that. That's a pastry cutter. We've got cookies. Cookie cutters, these are really cool.
Stars. And a million more shapes sizes you can.
Gosh.
This is just a sample of what
we have. Like in the shape of a dog bone and in the shape
lighthouse,
of...
I've seen it all.
All kinds of stuff. And these are really cool keepers. Like if you want to take some grapes for lunch, if you take grapes for lunch, they might be all squished by the time lunchtime comes around. So you've got this container that you can put your grapes in. I want to try one of these. This is a microwave onion cooker.
Yep.
Just put the nice big onion in there, put
it
in the microwave.
Care of the rest.
Yep.
And when you're cooking with some of these things here, you use half lemon, you use half lime, and you don't know what to do with the other half. You're throwing it away all the time, or you have half an avocado, so you're saving those other half for later by putting in one of these things, a little cute little thing, put it in
Perfect.
There. And you're not letting it go brown with the avocado, the other half goes brown, so this keeps
it
from doing that.
All of that is really, really good for you, especially the avocados. And of course, this is a handy little juicer here. It's a juicer just like everybody is used to. It goes down into this 2-cup glass container, and then when you want to pour it into whatever you're making, you just pour it right out
there
the spout. So it works really, really good. So it's cool to have all these fun gadgets.
Yeah.
And not only is it cool, but they're very, very useful too. So I think maybe I have found a couple extra gadgets that I might like to use in my kitchen. How about you, Hayden?
Me too. I think I'm ready to be a chef now.
Okay, we might have to take him up on it. So Hayden and I showing you all about gadgets. They make the coolest gadgets, don't they? Fun to see all the different things that they can do. Well, let's move on now to another popular segment that we've had, and that's how to prepare spaghetti squash. Yep, that's what it looks like, and you'll see more about how to prepare that with the wonderful marinara sauce that you can make out of the fresh tomatoes. So let's find out about, I believe it's called, twice-baked spaghetti squash. Well, we've made our way to the sampling station. This is my favorite place because this is where all the good food happens. And I'm here with Eileen once again.
Hello.
Always do a great job with
Thank
the cooking.
You.
So today we're going to talk about spaghetti squash.
Yes.
Now, I discovered spaghetti squash last year, but I haven't done a lot of different recipes. So today we're going to talk about different recipes with spaghetti squash.
And it is a winter squash, but it is available 12 months out of the year.
Okay.
Right now it's coming on out of North Carolina. It'll come on locally, and I mean 2 miles down the road from Townsend.
Great.
Delaware, from Fairview Farm, Steve McGann will be bringing us local.
Okay. So when the people are seeing this, it'll be local right here at Willey Farms. All right. And it's really good for you too. Just the squash itself. I was doing my research and I found out that a cup of the squash, only 31 calories.
Wow.
It's got lots of vitamins in it, particularly vitamin B6, which is apparently good for energy. Everybody needs more energy, and it's good for our liver. So you want a good liver, then have some spaghetti squash. So it's really good for you. So let's find out how we can actually cook it.
Yeah, well, the first thing we'll need to do, you wash it on the outside. You're gonna cut it in half. Really, you gotta be really strong. You're gonna dig in, cut it in half.
That's what I found out when I started using it. It's really hard.
Or you can submerge the whole thing, wash it real good, submerge the whole thing in boiling water.
Okay.
This one will take about an hour, hour and 15 minutes.
Wow.
Boiling. And then once your fork can pierce through the outer skin, it's ready to go.
Okay.
So that's the safe way.
So it's a little time consuming just getting it ready.
It is. but bake a little extra, or boil a little extra for the next time.
Right.
In the refrigerator.
Sure. Okay.
You know, the common thing for spaghetti squash is people think it tastes like spaghetti. It does not taste like spaghetti.
No, it doesn't.
So we'll talk about the recipes later. But the other way to cook it is, after you cut it in half, you're going to start gutting it.
I'm going to gut it. Okay.
Get out all that.
So you got to get
junk, just like we do a jack lantern.
Yep. Got to get that out. I get my garbage bowl.
Yeah, you have your garbage bowl. It's going to look like this. You want to clean all that out.
You got to get all the seeds.
It's going to be a little bit slimy when you're done cooking it. So you want to get all that out.
Right.
All this is going to cook. It's a very thin shell.
That's all the flesh.
The skin.
Okay.
The entire inside.
And we can start to see why it's called spaghetti squash.
Right. And I have one cooked, but the other two ways I want to talk about cooking is...
Okay.
The other way is if you put it in a casserole dish with a little bit of water. It's a steaming method.
Okay.
You put your two halves in
like
the water.
And you put the flesh up?
Flesh up.
Okay.
50 for this one, about 30 to 40 minutes. Again, when your fork can kind of pierce through, it's ready to go.
Okay.
The other way is on a baking sheet, turning it upside down.
Okay.
Put a little bit of vegetable oil on your cookie sheet, turning it upside down, and that's when you're going to get that charred look on the outside.
Oh, like a roasted.
Really nice, yes.
Yeah, okay.
Again, 30 to 40 minutes.
All right.
When you're able to pierce through it, and it's going to be upside down on the cookie sheet.
All right.
Right, and pierce through it.
Okay.
I'm going to show you one that's done. This is done.
Or say when it's done,
this
it comes out.
This is from the steam bath.
All right.
And we have to take all the guts out and things, and you're
going
to start forking it out. You're
okay.
Going to see that spaghetti.
And we'll see. We'll see why. Do I need to put my?
And I want you to do a dish for me. This is an easy one. Fork it out. Put it right in that bowl. We did four different dishes today. We're going to do the fourth one.
Okay. So we have the three other ones here.
Yes.
And all right.
After you fork it out, you'll notice this is just spaghetti squash and a basil pesto with a little bit of Parmesan cheese. Really easy.
It really is.
It tastes like spaghetti. It just depends on how you fix it.
Now,
with the spaghetti sauce.
We were, as always, when you do the cooking shows, you have to do prep. And you had prepped some things, and you had done some spices as you were cooking it.
I actually did a spaghetti squash, and of course this is already peeled out. I kind of forked it out.
Mm-hmm.
So, and it was just like it was in the beginning.
Right.
I put some steak seasoning in it and a little bit of garlic salt before I cooked it. And then I turned it upside down with that vegetable oil on the cookie sheet. And this is it. Oh my gosh, just like that, with a little bit of steak seasoning.
Oh yeah.
Delicious.
Yeah.
It has a nice side.
And it smells awesome too.
Your steak and your chicken, it's delicious. And
okay.
And I just worked it out and it's ready to go.
All right.
And I did 10 of them. I did 10 hands, so I did 5 whole.
Wow, herbs. So you're all prepped and ready for...
yesterday. So today when I put it together, it was so much easier.
Oh
yeah. You didn't have to wait that 30 or 40 minutes.
Right. So if you're planning ahead, which is what you should do, really, you can, after you've had your dinner, then you get it all prepped up, put it in the oven while you're watching television or doing something else,
right.
And then when it's done, you can put it in the refrigerator and you'll have it all ready to put together the next evening.
Right.
Now, how far down to the...
you can actually go further, but we're gonna get to the next...
Oh, okay.
There's even more. There's probably
there's more.
Cup.
Okay. All right.
That's a lot of squash. That's one hand. I mean, that's cool.
That's great.
It is.
And that's exactly why it's called spaghetti squash.
Now, this little bit of olive oil and garlic that I sauteed earlier.
Okay.
So if you want to just pour that in.
The whole thing in here? Okay.
And kind of get it around. And then a little bit of fresh parsley.
All right.
And then that one is done.
And that's done already?
Yeah, it's done.
Oh, my gosh. Okay. All right.
Salt and pepper, just to bring, get a little bit of, bring that flavor out of the parsley and garlic.
So does this have a name? Is this Eileen's special?
It's my favorite. It's so easy. And I love garlic and olive oil.
Oh, garlic is...
This one is my kid's favorite. This is a
twice-baked
spaghetti squash.
Oh, so twice-baked.
I roasted the spaghetti squash upside down in that olive oil cookie sheet yesterday.
Upside down, this one was. Okay.
I have my own homemade sauce I made for my husband's local tomatoes from Clayton Farms.
Oh, very good. Good commercial there. That's good. Nice plug.
I might get roses tonight. So, fresh spaghetti sauce in there, a little bit of mozzarella.
Mozzarella.
And then I baked it again at 350 for just about 12 minutes.
Just to get everything married together.
And serve it in the bowl.
Oh, everybody gets their own bowl?
Gets their own bowl.
Oh, wow. That's nice.
And the kids love it.
So you would take the fork and you would...
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, just fork it out.
So you would take it with it, it's got the sauce and everything, and then you would just start
chowing down.
So you could do a little bit there, and then you can take. So there it is. Wow.
It's just fun.
That's awesome. Okay.
And then the other one I have over here is this one? A summery salad. You know, we're just going into fall, so we're still doing the summer with the fresh tomato.
So this is served cold?
Room temperature.
Oh, okay.
Room temperature. It has feta cheese, fresh tomatoes, basil, and sliced black olives, and it's delicious.
Okay.
And it's served room temperature.
Well, I take
so
your...
Yesterday, warm it up in the microwave, and then throw that all together.
Oh, my. Okay.
Nice.
That is nice.
Now, we have more... It's not just spaghetti squash in the fall. We also have acorn squash, butternut squash, which are really great roasted.
Mm-hmm.
You know, or baked.
Right.
Do you do
them the same way?
You cut them in half, but I put those upside up with a little bit of water in that steam bath in the casserole dish. But I like to put brown sugar, cinnamon.
Oh.
You know, more of like a
and that's dirt. With the acorn squash.
Yes.
Okay. All right.
Okay, this is the olive oil and garlic.
Olive oil and garlic. Nobody will want to get near me for the rest of the day.
You're in the office anyway.
Simple, but good.
And you can taste the squash, the spaghetti squash.
And there's still, it's cooked, and it's the way it should be cooked, but you still get a little bit of crunch.
A little bit of al dente.
With that, yeah, with the spaghetti squash. So that is awesome. That's great. And this one over here is?
The basil pesto. Basil pesto, a little bit of Parmesan. You can use any kind of pesto, parsley pesto. Now the air got to it a little bit, so that's why it's fine. But this is delicious. Yeah, once you try that.
Okay. All right, oh.
Got it.
We almost lost the bowl there. All right, let's put that in there. There we go. All right, and this is the pesto, huh?
Basil pesto.
Oh, I love basil.
Mm-hmm. We did a segment on that not too long ago with parsley pesto, pine nuts, olive oil, garlic.
And the Parmesan.
Mm-hmm. Fresh Parmesan. Holy.
Very nice.
When you pick a spaghetti squash, you want a darker yellow color. They come light also.
Okay.
But it's not quite as ripe, so you want to go with
golden. Is that about...
Firm. It has to be firm.
Okay.
And very important.
All right, excellent. Okay, so we've got the room temperature kind of a salad here. This is more of a main course.
Yes, absolutely. Twice baked.
We've got the basil and Parmesan right there.
Pesto.
And this is the just the real basic.
Olive oil, garlic, parsley, nice side.
Okay. All right, I'm convinced.
Good.
I'm convinced.
Eat healthy.
We can
get rid of that starch.
That's true. You can substitute the spaghetti squash for the spaghetti pasta, and much better for you. So, and really, really good. So, you know what I say now?
Let's eat.
Dig in. Spaghetti squash is so good. I hope you enjoyed that. Something else really good? Fresh, local, sweet corn. And we've got a mountain of it here at Willey Farms. So stop by and get some of that. And coming up next, we're gonna use some of this sweet corn for a great fresh sweet corn salad. So here we are once again at the sampling station. That means food. And I'm here with Eileen. And today we're gonna start off, we're filming this in July, August. And so we wanna tell the folks about all of the wonderful local produce that we've got that's coming in here to Willey Farms. So Eileen, what do we have? We've got a great display here. About the local produce that
we have. A lot of local things coming from our local farmers right now. The reason why we want to talk local is local. It looks better, it tastes better, it's fresher. Basically everything here has been harvested within the last 24 hours, so going from farm to your table is very, very important.
And that's the thing that people need to know when they come to the farm markets here, as well as other farm markets.
Absolutely.
But when they come and they look at this, it's just been picked.
Yes. And it's coming within 20, 30 miles of their store.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's not coming from California, 1,500 miles plus.
Right, right.
And so on and so forth. And as the miles go on, you lose the nutrients. So the fresher, the more nutrients
The longer it's off the stem, the more the nutrients are going
away. Are lost.
Okay.
Yes. And we have quite a few things from our local farmers. We have the cantaloupes over here. They're coming from my husband in Denton, Maryland, Clayton Farms.
They're huge.
Aren't they amazing? They do everything big, not just Texas, but in Denton, Maryland. The tomatoes are for my husband, the kale, the The mint is from our backyard back here, as is the basil. We have the hydroponic lettuces, the red leaf and green leaf from Red Acres over there in Wharton, Maryland.
It just melts in your mouth.
It does. We have the red potatoes from Wicks and Lipsick, Smyrna, Delaware.
Right.
Area.
Makes a great red skin potato salad.
Papin Farms. I mean, we know these growers. We know them by their first names. I mean, this is what it is.
And that's why you deal with them.
Absolutely.
Right.
This is from Gary Calloway, the watermelons right now, from down in Seaford, Delaware. This is from my nephew, the okra. The tomatoes are from my nephew. The green beans are from my husband. Blueberries are from Hamilton, New Jersey.
It's a family business.
It really is. It
and
really
it's farmers
is.
Supporting farmers, too.
Absolutely.
Right, yeah.
And the farmers support the community. You buy local, and they, in turn, buy from the rest of the
and
area.
And if you buy local, you don't have to go 20 or 30 miles away. You just come around the corner and here we are and we've got local produce. So
that's right.
Great.
Yeah. And the flavor is more so now than it is not in season.
Seasonal
produce.
There's nothing like taking a fresh picked tomato and just pop it in your mouth. There's just nothing quite like it.
Correct. And I'll say the same thing in the fall, but it'll be a different array
of
produce.
Okay, so now we've got all this great fresh produce. Mm-hmm. There are some people that still do canning.
Oh, yes.
And freezing and everything.
Yes.
And we want to make sure that everybody knows that we have all of the canning supplies that you need, too. We've got the vinegar and the jars. Now, not only this size, but other sizes as well.
And don't forget, we carry in bulk, too, Donna. So what I have here, you may see it by the pound or in baskets or in bags, but I also sell it by the half bushel back in our wholesale department.
Oh, okay, right. So if you want to do a lot of canning, then
cases
you can do that.
Yes, cases of tomatoes, 25-pound boxes.
Okay, great. So we've got the pectin, and this is in particular for fruit, if you do want to do canning of fruit.
Yeah, keep it from browning.
Right, exactly. So we've got all these things, and the different sizes of the jars, too, not just the one size.
Yes, we have the jelly jar.
We've got lots of different sizes. So all the things that you need for canning, we've got them here. And if you don't see it when you come in, just grab somebody that's wearing one of these shirts and we'll be happy to tell you where it is and show you what we have. So great, we've got lots of fresh produce, canning supplies, and now I think we're gonna do a little do-si-do here. You're gonna move over here and I'm gonna come here. And we wanted to do something using that fresh produce. So what we're gonna make for you today is something called corn relish salad. And that uses fresh tomatoes, fresh peppers, and the corn, the wonderful sweet corn that's available right now. So, and it's very simple. There's no cooking unless you'd like to cook the corn. You can, or you don't have to, so it doesn't matter. So let's go right in with what we have. I'm gonna finish cutting this corn off the cob. I mean, why don't you show the folks this fancy little gizmo that we have that some people like to use, that you can use it.
I freeze between 500 and 600 ears of corn every year for my family. I have 5 daughters. Now I have a grandson and a son-in-law, so I freeze a lot of corn. So this is a really cool gadget. You grab an ear of corn, first of all, shuck it, get all the silk off, and you put the ear of corn inside here, and you push down on it, and it actually gets all this wonderful kernels.
Yeah,
just like that, it'll just push it right down. It fits right over it.
And that expands.
It does expand to the size of the corn.
To the size of the corn cob.
Yes, absolutely.
Awesome.
It has little forks in here, knife looking things.
Right.
But I tell you, since I do so many ears of corn, I will use one a year and have to buy one every year.
Buy a new one every time.
Because I do 650 at one time.
Okay. Remind me not to come over to your house when you're doing that.
It's so funny. I'll have a bin of corn out on the front lawn and all the kids. It's so embarrassing, but you know, they're used to it now.
Okay, so what we have is 3 cups of fresh corn, and you put that in the bowl. And then you have the tomatoes, which is the diced tomatoes. I'm just gonna dice one more. I don't know how the professional cooks do it, but this is how I dice,
like the color.
Dice up my tomatoes. Oh, and that's the other thing. The fresh is just so colorful. All right, so we've diced that. I'm going out of order, but that's okay. We have some vinegar that we put in here. We've got 1/3 cup of vinegar. We have 1/3 cup of sugar, and we have 1/4 cup of vegetable oil.
All right. And is that white vinegar?
White distilled vinegar. But I suppose if you have a favorite, you'd rather use that, you can do that. So you just kind of stir that around, and then you just start putting the ingredients in. So you've got your 3 cups of the corn.
And that corn is blanched, you said?
Yes, you can blanch it, or you can just put it in
fresh.
There fresh. It's fine that way.
It's so sweet right now.
It's awesome. Yeah,
and it's
awesome
even sweeter
right
in
now.
August. The cooler nights, that's when I freeze my corn, is in August.
Oh,
cooler
okay.
Nights, it's even sweeter.
All right.
Just so you've got... third week in August.
Oh, okay. All right. So we have, now we have a half, we have a cup of the diced tomatoes. We'll put the rest of those in there. And already the color is just awesome.
Yeah, I love it.
So we'll put the rest of these, this tomato in here. And then we need to have some more color. So we've got the green pepper.
That's a nice
and,
crunch.
And, you know, you just, everybody knows how to dice. See, like I say, I'm not a professional, so this is how I do it.
We need Susan, our chef, out here.
Yeah, that's right. That's right. So you put the beautiful green pepper in there. And then we've got, you can do a stir in between if you like. You can see how pretty it is.
Mm-hmm. Nice fresh summer salad.
Nice fresh summer salad. And you know, I do make this salad year round.
Oh.
It's beautiful in the season mm-hmm. with everything fresh, but it comes out pretty nice in the wintertime when you can use frozen corn. Hey, it's fresh when they put it in.
Oh,
the,
absolutely.
Fresh when they put it in the bag.
It's fresh and when
also,
they put it in the can.
Oh, yeah, exactly. And the diced tomatoes, you can buy a can of diced tomatoes. That works out well. But right now, we're okay. talking fresh, and it is so good. So we've got our juice, we've got our vegetables, and now we add cheese. Yeah. Everything goes better with cheese, right?
Always.
So this is a marble cheese. Kind of a Colby Jack sort of a thing. You put 8 ounces of the cheese in there. And again, if you have a favorite kind of a cheese, then use that instead mm-hmm. of the marble. But I kind of like this. And also some people, they might not like to bite down on a big chunk of cheese like that. So I have been known to get the
okay.
shredded cheese.
That's a good idea.
Put 8 ounces of the shredded cheese in there. It gives it a little bit different look. But the taste is still there, and it's really awesome. Then
this
you've
would
got,
be really good the next day.
Yeah, technically you're supposed to put it in the refrigerator, cover it,
okay.
and put it in the refrigerator
Let
for about 4 hours, and it marinates. You put a little bit of celery seed in there. That's a half a teaspoon, I believe.
Nice.
So yeah, you would put it in the refrigerator and chill it, and everything marries together, and mm-hmm. it marinates, and it tastes even better that way.
But you change it up and put a little bit of dill
sure.
or fresh parsley.
Yes, you can change it up the way you want, but
nice.
Essentially, there you go, your beautiful corn relish salad. Very delicious. As a matter of fact.
That'd be a meal for me.
I do that
especially with the cheese.
In the summertime,
mm-hmm.
I'll make that. There you go.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm. Little bit for me, and of course if you're having company over for a picnic,
really good.
It's great for a picnic. It's got all those wonderful flavors.
I like it. And this is Tom's corn.
Mm-hmm.
It's very good. And Kenny's peppers and Kenny's tomatoes.
So it's definitely a local salad.
Yes, it is.
Using all these wonderful local produce items mm-hmm. from the different farms. And we will have the recipe for you. If you like this, we'll be right here at the sampling station where we keep all the recipes. And so if you think you might like it, stop by, pick up a recipe. Corn relish salad, it's very easy. You saw how easy it was. Mm-hmm. And it's just chopping up a few things and mm-hmm. mixing it together. And the sweet and the sour of the vinegar
like
and the
it.
Sugar is kind of nice.
I like it.
Okay.
Support your local farmer.
Yeah. Yes, please support
yeah,
your local
come to Willey
farmer.
Farm,
we appreciate
support your
that.
Local farmer.
Yeah,
absolutely.
We try to do that, and we ask you to do that as well. But we would love to see you here anytime. So there you go. I hope you try that out. Thank you, Eileen, for helping with the canning and the local produce.
Absolutely.
Okay. Well, thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed that, and I hope you try out that new corn relish salad recipe. We're here at Willey Farms, very easy to find, Route 13. Just cut off Route 1 in Odessa and come south, or get off North Smyrna and come north. We're right here on Route 13, open every day at 8 o'clock in the morning until 7 o'clock at night. And we're very excited right now that we're in the middle of our summer butterfly project. I'm standing here next to our butterfly habitat. We've got a great poster that shows you all of the stages of the monarch butterfly, and we're actually growing butterflies. It is so cool. We invite you to bring your kids or your grandkids or your neighbor kids. Bring them over, and so we can show them how the process works. They start as little teeny tiny baby caterpillars. They go into a chrysalis, and then they emerge as a butterfly. So we hope that you get to experience that sometime in the next few weeks here at Willey Farms. Thanks for watching. You have a great day, and be sure to check us out on Facebook or our website page, which is willeyfarmsde.com. Have a great day.